run through someone, try to tape the open? What? If you just talk, if he's wearing his headsets, he'll hear you. I don't think he's got them on yet. But yeah, that's, if I tell you to turn your key off, you just hit that. If you don't want to talk, just hit that. Right now it's on. Just make sure, yeah, you're supposed to be on 16 by 9. Make sure you guys have like the same. And then for, you got autofocus. Probably the easiest. You might have to, there it is. I don't think it's that sunny yet where you need to do that. You'll probably keep it there. It's not sunny. But you know, as it gets sunnier, you can close the aperture.
How many games are there?
Four, so. First one's gonna be messy. I hope not. So you're? Yeah, I mean, it all depends. It's like a football game, technically, so it's only 12 minutes. It all just depends.
I was just wondering.
Well, they could go longer. Like, they told me a game could go all the way up to 2 hours. It just depends on the score. Every time they score, the clock stops. It's a high-scoring game.
I don't know.
That's awesome. So, you want to talk to him? See if Mike's there. Mike?
Mike. What settings are you on?
Yeah, okay, you have to figure that out.
Grip. Good luck today. Tied off on your belt.
Yeah, but get the shoot down the roof.
Sure.
Sure.
I can talk like crazy. What do you want me to say? Welcome to South County Stadium, Port St. Lucie, Florida.
Test.
Hello. Welcome to South County Stadium, Port St. Lucie, Florida, for the Final Four of the Girls State Lacrosse Championship. Is that all right?
You still need
Yes, test. We're here in South County Stadium, here in beautiful Port St. Lucie.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Not real loud, but I can hear him.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Hello, we welcome everyone to South County Stadium in Port St. Lucie, Florida. Today we have the girls' Final Four, lacrosse finals. Our first match will be the Bishop Moore Hornets from the Orlando area and Bartram Trail, the Bears from the Jacksonville area. Actually, they're from St. John's, Florida. All right. Okay, so once I get, all right, so just basically, hello, welcome, set.
We're here at the stadium right. Where number, you know, where 14-5 Lady Panthers are taking two lullabies.
Okay.
Hey, tell me a little bit about, right. You know, Bishop, what can we expect?
All right.
It's just got to be quick, pretty, flowing. You, just a few sentences about the visiting team, and then, you know, whatever y'all decide to talk about. Like,
okay.
You don't have to give out too much stuff, because you're going to have a long game. To, like,
all right.
You know,
so this is real then?
Yeah, we're just going to do a real run through and see what, just so we know, because just so we get a feel for it, then you guys can also watch the monitor as well,
okay.
And that should show you what's happening.
All right.
All right, camera 1 and 2, regroup, please. So yeah, let's just do a whole complete run through.
You're
good morning. We welcome everyone to South County Stadium in Port St. Lucie, Florida. Today we're going to bring you the Final Four of the Girls State Lacrosse Championships. In our first semifinal game, it'll be the Lady Hornets of Bishop Moore High School against the Lady Bears of Bartram Trail. I'm Martin O'Neill. I'm alongside Bob Windsor. Bob is the girls' lacrosse coach at Martin County High School. So Bob, give us a little rundown on what we can expect today from Bishop Moore.
Well, Bishop Moore is a team that I've seen play a couple of times this year, Martin, and I can tell you they're very fast. So we're going to see a lot of scoring, probably early. The Bartram Trail team I haven't seen yet, but I'm expecting this to be a very close game, probably the best game of the Final Four.
Thanks, Bob. We're looking forward to it as well. And again, Bishop Moore out of the Orlando area and Bartram Trail from around Jacksonville. Actually, I think they're from St. John's, Florida. So it should be a great opening match. Look forward to working with you today.
We got a beautiful day.
All right, let's try that again because I just want to get the camera shot straight.
All right.
Is that all right?
Yeah, I thought that went good or went well.
All right.
We done good.
Bartram, what can we expect?
Good morning. We welcome everyone to South County Stadium in Port St. Lucie, Florida. Today we're going to bring you the Florida High School Athletic Association's Final Four Girls Lacrosse semifinal games. In the early match, we'll have Bishop Moore, the Lady Hornets, matched up with the Bartram Trail Lady Bears. I'm Martin O'Neill, and I'm working alongside today Bob Windsor. Bob is currently the girls lacrosse coach at Martin County High School. Bob, tell us what you know about Bishop Moore.
Well, Bishop Moore is a team that I have scouted a couple times this year, and I can tell you they're very, very fast. They're like lightning. Very good stick skills, very high scoring.
Have you had a chance to watch at all Bartram Trail this year?
I have not seen them. They come out of the Jacksonville area, a little bit too far for me to drive up to see how they're playing, but it's a very competitive area, and I'm expecting a very closely fought game.
Very good. We look forward to both matches today, and certainly the early game, at least on paper, looks like it'll be a really close match. So sit back, enjoy the first semifinal game. Okay, so we're going to go live on this one then? Okay. All right, so we're going to start what we just did again and do it again after the national anthem.
It's going to be after the national anthem, they go right into the game. Okay. So you might have to just do it a little quicker. Like, hey,
okay.
I'm, okay. You want to be quick. Like, here we are for the first of, four semifinal games today. Today, first one is so-and-so. Okay.
It'll be 5 minutes in between that.
Yeah.
Yeah, because what's going to happen, they'll have the national anthem, then the coaches will talk to their players. They'll say, come on over here, and they'll give like a last-minute thing.
Yeah, we
and then they'll come out for the draw.
We get this whole bit in,
so
I think.
So we'll have 3 or 5 minutes.
Yeah.
That would be my guess now.
No, I think they'll do the national anthem. They're bringing them out now.
They're going to announce the girls.
Yeah.
They'll do the national anthem, and then they'll go to the sidelines.
Yeah.
And the coach will talk to them. This is where I usually get the team together. I say kill, kill, kill. And 25.
We're good. We're waiting for the national anthem once it's done.
Those things fell over. I thought something was going to fall on my head. Yeah, I was ready to, to go down. And with these on, it was kind of just was that much louder. I thought. I don't know why. I felt it. Yeah, in that broadcast, they sent me, there was no, they didn't show the clock the whole time. One from South Carolina, I don't think it was your production, but I know that there was no clock. Is that frustrating or what? Ow.
Nothing's going on just yet. I mean, they're having a PA problem. Was that a Notre Dame thing?
Sounded like it.
It's okay.
I told Barbara, I said I didn't recognize Barbara without her headband on.
Yeah.
She always wears a headband.
All right, they're sending him to the sideline. I guess they're not doing introductions because the mic's... Right.
And they still can't start till 11.
Right.
At the earliest.
What does that mean?
Well, I mean, they may maybe they start 11:02 or 11:03.
Well, that explains a few things. I wonder why she's not starting. She's on crutches. And I wonder if that's five walking next to her because she's the captain, Larinaga. And looks like she might be in a sling.
But when we do the boys game, don't ask me if I've seen the teams play.
We'll work off their reputation.
Yeah.
You know, Lake Highland won last
year. St. Andrews is considered the hero of the boys game.
Yeah, but last year they lost to Lake Highland.
Yeah.
11-10.
But they travel up north. They play boys Latin up in D.C. or whatever.
Yeah. Yep. Boy, do I understand that one. Just turn the mic on. I don't touch anything, but that's it. You got it. Yeah, that can be.
25-0. Would have done this earlier, like yesterday.
Well, I think they're planning to still go off at, you know, at 11. I mean, I would think. I know there's walkie.
Oh, this here you want?
The good stuff.
Wasn't quite sure.
The good stuff. All right, their players are up, so they must be getting ready to go on.
Yeah. They're probably not going to do the national anthem either.
Yeah, they said that's not going to go off. They don't have they're having all kinds of PA problems. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Let's go with two. Yep. Good morning. We welcome everyone to South County Stadium in Port St. Lucie, Florida. The 2012 FHSAA Final Four for Girls. Semifinal lacrosse matchup featuring the Bishop Moore Lady Hornets and the Bartram Trail Lady Bears. I'm Martin O'Neill, working alongside the Martin County girls coach, Bob Windsor. Bob, tell us a little bit about Bishop Moore as we get ready to start here today.
Well, Bishop Moore is a team that I've seen play a couple of times this year, and I got to tell you, they're very, very fast. So we're going to see a very high-powered offense out of them. Bartram Trail I have not seen, but they come from a very tough area up and around Jacksonville, St. John's, and so I'm surprised if we don't see a very closely fought game here today, very high scoring.
Great. We're looking forward to the match, and the girls, of course, are taking the field as we speak and getting ready to start with our opening draw. Bishop Moore out of the Orlando area, and as Bob suggested, Bartram Trail actually from the Jacksonville area, from St. John's, Florida. All right. On the draw for Bishop Moore, number 11, Claire Ferry. On the draw for Bartram Trail, number 21, Melissa Coggins. Be a 25-minute half and a brief halftime, followed by a second 20-minute half. And the goal today, make it to the state finals, which will be tomorrow afternoon. Bob, your last-minute instructions to your team would have been what?
Score as many goals as you can.
All right, we'll see who can score the most today. Here we go. Ball is up, game on. Away of the ball, Bishop Moore. The Hornets on the run, pass number 22. Jackie Servacio.
There's
ahead, looks like number 13, got a shot. Nice play by the goalkeeper, Bob. Explain that one.
Well, there's that speed we were talking about. Bishop Moore ran right through, but it looks like the Bartram Trail girl went into the crease, which is a violation.
Well, Chloe Sebagas is going to start play now for Bishop Moore. Bishop Moore behind on the offensive side here behind the net.
They're a very good catching team.
Yep.
You'll see some good passing.
Bishop Moore on the move. That's Lindsay Tangeman. Flips it a ball over number 13, Bridget Larinaga. Bishop Moore looking for an offensive chance. Haley Kakris. Bishopmore again. Looking for an opportunity, I think. Ball comes free. Scooped up by Kayla Jones, goalkeeper for Bartram Trail.
And she tried to roll the crease there, but that was good defense.
And Bears with their first possession of the game. Long throw out. Ball rolls free. Bartram Trail comes up with the ground ball. It's number three, Casey Coates, racing into the offensive end of the field. Pass a little bit high over the head of her intended player. Ball rolls out and belongs now to Bishop Moore. Looks like Kathleen Malloy will start play for the Hornets.
It's our first forced turnover of the game.
Yep. Bishop Moore, long throw out. Nice catch by Lindsay Tangeman. Flips it ahead to number 13, Bridget Larinaga, and Bishop Moore to the attack. Bishop Moore moving the ball perimeter, looking for an opportunity, I'm sure, to get inside. Bob, what are you really looking for here if you're a member of the Hornets team?
Well, you want to see how the other team's going to set up on defense, and Bartram Trail is playing a man-to-man defense against them. So I'm sure they have an offense set up for whatever kind of defense Bartram Trail is going to throw up against them.
All right, whistle stop play, Bob. Call would have been what? Got a Bishop Moore taking a shot. Looks like Lindsay Tangeman on goal. So with 22 minutes, 27 seconds to play in the opening half, Lady Hornets jump out 1-0. Stoppage of play there by the official, Bob. What do you think?
You know, I didn't. Okay. I didn't see what had happened there.
Bishop Moore found their opportunity and jumps out to a 1-0 lead. Looks like number 21, Melissa Coggin, taking the draw for the Bears. And looks like number 11, Claire Ferry, on the draw for Bishop Moore. Give me a key thing to be looking at here on the draw control, Bob. And what are you expecting from your players?
Well, the girls, you want to draw towards your offensive zone because then it's just a shorter trip into that area.
Obviously, a tall player like Ms. Ferry certainly helped out Bishop Moore there.
Well, she drew the ball to herself.
Yeah.
She attempted to take advantage of that height.
Whistle stops play, and it looks like Lindsay.
Number 21
wide open. 15,
open.
Haley Hagblood for Bartram Trail. Flips it ahead to number four, Mary Kay Weaver. Whistle stops play there.
That was with a push.
All right, for the push, and Weaver on the attack for the Lady Bears. Wow, she dashes inside, takes a shot, got a goal.
Went hard to goal. We're going to see that a lot today.
Yeah, it was a really nice move. I've not had a chance too much, Bob, to really see Bishop Moore's defense. They're playing man-to-man today.
They were set up in a man-to-man, but you're right that they were really weren't in their set defense yet there.
Mary Kay Weaver taking advantage of the opportunity for the Lady Bears, and we're all even at one, 21 minutes and 54 seconds to play in the opening half. Coggin, number 11, Ferry, taking the draw for their respective teams. What a gorgeous day here, huh?
Beautiful, beautiful.
I bet it's hot down on the field. All right, ball is up. Control by no one at the moment. It looks like number 11, Claire Ferry, comes away with it for Bishop Moore. Flips it ahead, Lindsay Tangeman.
Here they go.
Yep. Nice play, number 22 comes away at this point, Jackie Servasio, and a whistle stops play.
There's an illegal check and a spear.
Illegal check, it'll stay with Bishop Moore. Flips it ahead, number 13, Bridget Larinaga.
Oh.
Had a nice opportunity inside, just off the stick. Bishop Moore retains possession, Chloe Sebagas. And we had a whistle stopping play there, and now the ball goes to the Bears. Kayla Jones, possession as a goalkeeper. Nice pass out. Beautiful catch there. Number three, Casey Coates. And the Lady Bears running in open field. Bears control. Flips back number seven, Jane Rudy.
You're going to see that a lot. You're going to see a lot of illegal checks.
Yeah, which is pretty standard in the girls' game, right, Bob, as you try to tightly, you know, play against the player with the ball. It's Casey Coates. You were saying?
They're much stricter this year with the illegal checks. Cannot check towards the body.
Carolyn Beggs. Looking inside, takes a move, got a shot, defended by the keeper, got a second shot by Bartram Trail. Looks like we have a goal.
Yeah, I believe that first shot hit the post.
Yeah, I think you're right. I'm not exactly sure of who scored on that play, but Bartram Trail jumps out 2-1. 20 minutes, 20 seconds to play in the opening half. Go back to checking for a minute, Bob. I mean, the game of lacrosse for girls is similar to boys, I mean, basketball in that regard. I mean, you can kind of check a player without having physical contact with them.
Well, you can use your stick to check the ball out of the other player's stick, but you cannot check towards the body. Most of the girls' lacrosse rules are safety issues, so they don't want any time the stick going towards the body of the other player.
Melissa Coggins and Claire Ferry on the draw. It's 2-1, Bartram Trail. Claire Ferry comes out of it for Bishop Moore.
There's that height.
Yeah. At some point this morning, I wanted to talk a little bit about what you train your goalkeeper to do. I mean, I've watched the game a little bit, and it seems to me it's really difficult as a goalkeeper sometimes to take care of people taking shots at you. So I'm not sure how you coach them up, but we get a chance here, maybe at halftime or get a timeout. We'll take a look at it and
sure.
Tell me how you train up your goalkeeper. All right, we got number 13, Bridget Larinaga, with the ball for Bishop Moore. Claire Ferry. Nice moves inside, but again, defense takes it away. Ball rolls free. Looks like Lindsay Tangeman got it, had it, lost it.
Ooh, that's a cover.
Looks like Sophie Kuzma, number 17, going to start play for the Bears. Had a checking foul there, Bob.
Yes, it was. Towards the body.
Yep. Looks like Kuzma's going to start
playing. Just a little bit more physical play than they're going to allow at this game.
Yeah. Ball's checked free.
Good check there.
Rolls in. Collision between players. That drew a call.
They're going to call a push. They're going to call a toss because both players pushed. So okay. I guess they can. Each referee called a different player, so they're going to call a toss.
Like Chelsea Worrell or Bishop Moore. I did not get the number of the girl from Bartram Trail, but there it is, number 17.
Oh.
That would have been Sophie Kuzma.
They're going to retoss that.
Yeah, it's like Kuzma and Worrell, and tee it up. Worrell, one of the co-captains for Bishop Moore.
You don't see that too often.
Yeah. Ball free. Kuzma comes away with it. Nice play for the Lady Bears. Running in the open field. That's number 9, Courtney Schell. Now the Bears set up their offense. Number 1, Carolyn Beggs behind the net. Nice pass inside. Shot number 21 was Lindsay Coggin, one of the co-captains for the Bears. Nice stop by the goaltender for Bishop Moore.
Great stop.
Nicole Vella, number 30, is the Bishop Moore goalkeeper, and she made a heck of a stop on that. It was a near point blank shot. All right, Bishop Moore, Lindsay Tangeman, long pass out. Ahead to number 22, Jackie Servasio. Onto the attack in open field from the Lady Hornets. All right, Chelsea Worrell. Bishop Moore behind the back of the net. Passes outside to Haley Kakris. Number 6 is Chloe Sebagas. She's free inside momentarily, and a whistle will stop play.
With a push.
So she's going to have a direct? Is that what this is?
She's going to get a free shot here.
A free shot from 8 meters away. Kayla Jones, goalkeeper for the Bears.
Free position shot.
Comes inside, takes a shot. So Vegas ties it up. We're at 2-2, 17 minutes, 8 seconds to play. Let's talk about goalkeepers for a second, Bob. How do you defend that?
You guess.
That's really it.
You take away something, and then you anticipate that going where you're not. Depends how fast your goalie is. Depends how much room they take up.
But clearly a disadvantage to the goalkeeper in those situations. I mean, you got an offensive player running at you, and they pretty much know where they want to go, and you're guessing.
Well, if they're fast, there's not much you can do but guess right, because they're going to get in as close as they can on you. If your defense is set up to slow them down, then you got a shot.
All right. Melissa Coggins, co-captain for the Lady Bears, taking the draw with Claire Ferry from the Lady Hornets. Been exciting so far and very close, huh, Bob?
This has been very exciting, everything we thought was going to be. I think this is going to be a nail-biter.
Game on. Looks like Bishop Moore's going to get advantage of that. It was number 22, Jackie Servasio, starting play for the Lady Hornets.
Good defense stopping that fast break.
Chelsea Worrell had the ball for the Hornets momentarily. She passed off to Haley Kakris. Back to Larinaga. Tangerman. Nice catch inside. There's number 13, Bridget Larinaga. Again, Bishop Moore looking for their opportunity to try to regain the lead. Scramble for the ball, and it looks like the Bears. Yes, number 9 for the Bears, that's Courtney Schell. Flips it back to Kayla Jones, their goalkeeper, who's also one of their co-captains. Ball a little high, a little long, picked up by Tangerman for the Lady Hornets. 13, Larinaga. She is fast, 13, Bridget Larinaga. Number 6, Sebagas. Nice pass inside, shot a little bit high. Like close to the ball when it rolled out, number 22, Servasio, and Bishop Moore possession. Tangerman. Ferry, nice pass inside just off the stick of the Bishop Moore player. Scramble ensues. Looks like they're giving the ball to the Bears. Number 23, Kaylin Burgess, will start play for Bartram Trail.
Another cover there.
And she ran out of play. Yeah, I think she probably got lost on the field there. Thought the
she did not realize.
She thought the orange line was the out of bounds.
Yes,
and actually it was white.
I was actually wondering why she was crossing that line.
Kakris starts play for Bishop Moore. Flips over to Worrell. Ferry to Lindsay Tangerman, and Lady Hornets in what's been an exciting close match. Servasio, again, Bartram Trail defense playing stout, turning her away.
A lot of pressure put on by Bartram Trail there.
Kind of dashing inside was number 1 Tangerman. Ball rolls out. Bob in lacrosse, the person closest to it when it goes out on a shot retains possession for their team, correct?
It's actually the closest stick.
The closest stick.
So you should see the girls run with their sticks straight out in the air trying to reach to that point.
Sebagas. Pass inside. Ball comes free.
I think you're going to get stepping in the crease there when she picked up the ball.
Okay. Kaylin Burgess, number 23 for Bartram Trail. And on that, we're back in play.
Bishop Moore's putting a lot of pressure on
the... Yeah, Devin Romer for the Bears. And again, Bishop Moore is. It's been a very tightly defensed match.
Yeah, they're in a full field man-to-man ride.
Devin Romer, check that. It was Bishop Moore got possession, went out of Devin. Lady Hornets, Lindsay Tangerman. We've got a whistle-stopping play again. Illegal check, Bob?
Yes.
Okay. Number 4, Chelsea Worrell will start the play for the Lady Hornets.
We'll see that a lot today.
Yeah, I'm sure. Number 13, Bridget Larinaga.
A lot of pressure way out to the restraining line. You don't see that too often.
Claire Ferry. Defended by number 4, Mary Kay Weaver. Kelly Chris, nice pass inside. Great stop.
Great stop.
Kayla Jones coming up big for the Bears. passes out.
Very,
that's a
very
nice
athletic
throw and
catch.
Yes, nice throw and catch there. Number three, Casey Coates. For the illegal check again.
Again.
Okay, Casey Coates will restart play for the Lady Bears. We're back in play. Nice move. Steps between the two defenders again. Carolyn Beggs behind the net for Bartram Trail. Number 21, Melissa Coggins. Dashes inside, takes the shot, finds the back of the net.
She buried it.
12 minutes to play in the opening half, and Bartram Trail regains the lead. It's now 3-2. Been back and forth. Bishop Moore scored first. Next two goals by Lady Bears went up 2-1. They're now up 3-2. Tell me what you're seeing with the – I feel like we have a timeout, Bob. Tell me what you're seeing from Bishop Moore's defense. They look a little unsettled or porous, perhaps.
Well, they're not pushing out as far as the Bartram Trail is, but they're playing good man-to-man, but Bartram Trail's moving the ball very fast.
But you do. I mean, there is quite a bit of a difference in the defensive pressure we're seeing today, correct?
Sure. They're both playing man-to-man, but Bartram Trail is really putting a lot of pressure on the ball well outside of the fan, 12-meter fan. He's got a lot of energy in the stands here today, Martin.
Yeah, I was kind of looking out. I'm thinking it's a Friday. It's 11. One team is from Jacksonville area, one's from the Orlando area, and I can see the Bishop Moore fans seem to outnumber the fans from Bartram Trail, but still impressed with the number of student-age fans that are in the stands. So obviously, big event at a school, huh?
Well, it's, you know, potentially a state championship situation.
It's a school day. You're at Martin County, and your team's in it. Are the kids in school today, or are they here supporting their classmates?
If they're given the option to missing school, I think they'll go with missing school.
I think every time. But it's nice to see the crowd out. I mean, it is a nice-sized crowd for a match like this. First time that the...
I think you're going to see our second game today. You're going to see that much of a bigger crowd.
Well, one of the teams plays fairly close to here. But first time that the finals have actually been held here, and it's a really nice facility.
Beautiful.
You've gotten to play here, I take it.
Never played here.
Really? Okay, you've called timeout, and if you're Bishop Moore and you're their coach, what's your point?
Well, you know, knowing how much they like to fast break, I'm surprised they're not fast breaking a little bit more. They're really, if it's not there, they're really going into a settled offense, and they're forcing the passes into the 8 meters. Mm-hmm. I think they're going to make better passes when they're in their settled offense, and I'd like to see them run a little bit more because they have tremendous speed.
And if you're Bartram Trail, you're just saying keep on?
Yeah.
I mean, they look good.
It's working for them.
Yep. Chloe Sebagas looks like she's taking the draw at this time for Bishop Moore. I haven't gotten the number on the Bartram Trail player. It's been their captain, Melissa Coggins, so far through the first half. Ball gets placed between the 2-6, correct?
Yes, it does. A new rule this year, they put it place it in the very top of the sticks.
I see. All right, number 7, actually, Jane Rudy took the draw for Bartram Trail, but again, draw control to Bishop Moore. See, they follow Bob's advice and start moving the ball a little more crisply and looking making better catches and throws inside. Chloe Sebagas has the ball. Flips it over to her teammate. Looks like number 1, Lindsay Tangeman, races in, takes a shot. Bishop Moore retains possession.
Good defense there.
Yeah. Looks like Jackie Servasio is going to restart for the Hornets. Sebagas Tangeman. Ferry. You're right, that defense for Bartram Trail Bob really is.
Really pushing it out.
Yeah,
really
they're not giving any space at the moment to the Bishop Moore players. There's a Tangeman. Nice catch and throw there. Like Zoe McFarland. Or Zoe McFarland. So Vegas passes inside. Finally, it worked out. Chelsea Worrell, one of the co-captains for Bishop Moore, finds the back of the net, and we're back to level with 10:41 to play in the opening half.
And it was a much more deliberate pass they made into the 8 meters there. They didn't force it. It was there, and they made a nice pass.
One thing about Bartram Trail's defense, it is going to allow some space inside. I mean, if you're a Bishop Moore player, that's what your coach is saying to you, be patient.
Sure, if you beat the pressure, there's going to be opportunities there for you.
And the purpose of the defense right now for Bartram Trail is to keep them from having any space, make them make mistakes.
They're trying to force a play and maybe cause some turnovers outside.
Mm-hmm. All right, co-captain Jane Rudy taking the draw for Bartram Trail, and number 6, Chloe Sebagus for Bishop Moore. We're going to do that one again, I think.
Yeah, ball's got to go up a certain height.
There it is. It's a Vegas.
She draws
nice pass into Tangeman. Nice catch. Nice throw. Bishop Moore looking to take advantage of the opportunity of space inside. Nice play inside. Found it. Number 22, Jackie Servasio. Found the open space, found the back of the net. And Bishop Moore now with a 1-goal lead, 4-3, with 10 minutes and 25 seconds to play. Bob, fast break.
I would say Bishop Moore made some changes in the last huddle, and it's worked for them. There was two good passes into somebody wide open, and they took advantage of it.
And it seems like on the last two possessions as well, they have not been, look like for a while, maybe, you know, like you were saying, they're trying to feel it out and see what they're doing.
Well, I'm sure there's some jitters, you know, in a high-pressure game like this. And, you know, maybe it just took them a few minutes to settle down and be patient. But they were much more patient the last two times down the field.
Obviously, a well-used timeout for Bishop Moore than if they come out of that and kind of grab the lead here. All right, Coggan and Sebagus on the draw. Claire Ferry on the attack for the Lady Hornets.
Well, it's a big advantage when you can score and then get the ball back right away.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, Tangeman, Worrell, Servasio. Out front with the ball. Number 6, Sebagus, Ferry. Tangeman, nice throw inside. Nice defense there. Came pretty quickly to support what looked to be a pretty easy shot for a moment.
Sure, we're going to get a push there.
Sophie Kuzman, number 17 for Bartram Trail. The player for Bishop Moore is Chloe Sebagus, number 6. A trip to the finals awaiting the winner of this match, and it has been tight. Tangeman, Claire Ferry. Vegas, McFarland, and again, Bishop Moore running their offensive scheme. Once again, Bartram Trail, this man-to-man, hard and in your face.
Illegal check in the spear.
Right, Servasio. Worrell.
Yeah, they're really being patient here.
Yeah. Just create such space in that. Down inside the 8, if you can get a player there and the Bartram player is not quick to cover. Claire Ferry back to Jackie Servasio. Bishop Moore again, patient, looking for the opportunity. Bartram Trail not giving him much. Zoe McFarland. Nice catch. Ball got away from Sebagus. Trip.
I would say so.
Cards do come out in this game occasionally. We haven't seen a situation that would bring It was a trip. It wasn't intentional, but because it was such a violent fall, Bob, I mean, is that
I guess it was a little bit more
blatant and then inadvertent.
Okay.
And so what happens here is she's going to be off the field for 2 minutes, and whether the other team scores or not, she stays out for 2 minutes.
Mary Kay Weaver taking advantage of open field, running into the attacking zone. Bishop Moore tries to shut off her advance, but not today. Mary Kay Weaver, for the second time today, puts one in the back of the net for the Lady Bears. With 7 minutes and 59 seconds to play in the opening half, it's now knotted at four. All right, so I'm on the bench for 2 minutes. Who's keeping track of my time?
Well, there's a timer on the sidelines here.
One of the officials.
But one rule change this year, Martin, is you have to play a man down in your defensive zone. So with Bishop Moore having the penalty against them, there was only six people in the defensive zone. Where last year you could transfer a player from the other side of the field and fill up with a seven.
So a card penalty pays a greater penalty to your
team. Much greater penalty.
Oh. Okay, on the draw this time, Melissa Coggins, number 21, co-captain for the Bartram
Bartram trail. Wants to try to score as many goals as they can here.
At this moment, absolutely. So Chloe Sebagas for Bishop Moore. Bishop Moore has been on the draw control this morning.
Yeah, that's a big advantage.
Yep.
Now they're going to try to run that clock down now so that they can run that 2 minutes off. So they're going to take their time. You're not going to see them go to goal. Yeah, they spread it out. They're going to throw it around.
Even given the fact that Bartram Trail still presses on defense, you've still got your players going, no. Now, would you wait until she's back on to shoot? I mean, or you just simply running clock and...
You just want to run the clock down.
Okay.
And Bartram Trail should want to double-team the ball. They have an extra player because there's only six people for Bishop Moore at that end of the field. So they should be double-teaming the ball here.
They're trying to press and take advantage, get the ball back in their possession.
Correct.
I think Chelsea Worrell, Jackie Servasio, Lindsay Tangeman weaving through the defense, but boy, there's not much space there. Nice play by the goalkeeper, kind of turn that aside. Bishop Moore retains possession, back to the attack, number six, Worrell. Out front, Lindsay Tangeman. Now, when a girl comes back on the field in this situation, Bob, how do your players who are intently involved in the action, got a shot, got a goal, looks like Claire Ferry finds the back of the net, and Bishop Moore retakes the lead 5-4. When your player's coming back into play, how do the players that are involved in such intense action know, or is that something they just don't pay attention to?
Well, they're really paying attention to what's going on the field, so they know, or they'll see somebody all of a sudden show up, and then they'll know that they're back to full strength, or the coach will yell out to them.
Give you a cue that they're in. Obviously, well played by Bishop Moore there. They ran off the penalty and scored a goal.
Yeah, they almost ran the penalty off. There's still a little bit of time left on the penalty. You notice the Bishop Moore player in the box over there getting ready to run in.
That's why you're here, man. I need someone that understands the game. Well played. Okay, so the girl in the box is still out.
Correct. She's got to stay in the box, and when the time's up, someone will let her know and she'll run into the game, as long as there's no whistle.
Very cool. All right. Looks like Sebagas. Yep, Sebagas and Coggin. Draw control this time, well, it looks like for probably the first time in the game, goes to Bartram Trail.
It's been a while since they won.
It has. Courtney Schell on the outside, racing upfield with the ball. Behind net to Beggs. Caroline Beggs. She looks inside, takes a shot.
Man. That was a nice hesitation shot there. She faked the goalie, and the goalie went for it, and she moved the goalie and then fired to the open spot.
Well, it can't get a whole lot closer than this, ladies and gentlemen. It's 5 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the opening half. It's dead even at five. Neither team's had a bigger goal than one. And it's just the way Bob drew it up at the beginning of the game. He said, I think this is going to be the closest game of the semifinals. And so far, it's lived up to the hype.
And both teams are back at full strength now.
Sebagas and Coggins taking the draw. All Well, if it stays like this, it's going to be one of those games that's going to be great to win it, and it's going to feel lousy if you don't.
There's a lot on the line.
Yeah, there is. And Bartram Trail to the attack, and a whistle stopping play. That was Lauren Hutzel, who will have possession
illegal
of the
check.
Bears.
Illegal check.
Are we getting the card out of this?
Yeah, I was going to say she's fixing her goggles. Well, a lot of times that means the goggles got hit by the stick.
It looked like a pretty aggressive defense there by the player from Bishop Moore, who's going to the sideline. And she'll have a two-minute visit with her coach. Lauren Hutzel, I'm pretty sure, will have play for the Bartram Trail Bears. And that's 8 meters out. It's a direct, correct, Bob?
Correct. She's got a bad angle, but watch for a pass into the box.
Yeah.
No, she pulls it out.
Hutzel comes around, looks inside. Bishop Moore, good defense inside now.
Again, with the penalty,
Jane,
you're going to see Bartram Trail go hard to goal.
Yeah. The nice job of Bishop Moore kind of denied them that opportunity. It looks like they really kind of tightened up their defensive end a little bit. Coming free with the ball, Bridget Larinaga. She raises up field.
There's that speed I was talking
about.
Yeah,
she's like lightning. Nice pass to Sebagus. Bishop Moore to the attack.
They're gonna run the clock down now. Try to burn off that penalty.
Yep. Lindsay Tangeman out front. It's Claire Ferry, possession for Bishop Moore.
They'll be in no hurry.
Yeah. Sebagus to Ferry over to Tangeman. Yeah, you're right. Looks like a four corners offense and basketball or something. It's just a matter of spreading the field and keeping possession.
And when you have the extra player, you do want to double team the ball here.
Yeah.
Which Bartram Trail is doing now. They didn't do that the last time, but they are doing it this time.
Servacio, whistle it, stop play there. She's back in possession. Comes inside, takes a shot. And I guess you take advantage of the chance
the
when
shot's
it's there.
Yeah. It's a good opportunity. What the heck?
Jackie Servacio for the Bishop Moore Hornets. And 4:37 to play in the half. It's now 6-5. What's interesting is that in the semifinals, both boys and girls, some of the teams have faced each other during the regular season. Of course, neither of these two saw each other this year. Did you see either of these two teams in Martin County?
Bishop Moore, I saw them play Benjamin. Not Benjamin, I saw them play St. Ed's in a tournament there. Always looking to watch good teams play.
Yep. So Vegas and Coggins. That's going to be
ball's
it. Got to
go
draw.
Above the shoulder.
Yep.
Both girls are taking a draw control here, are trying to draw to themselves.
Yeah, it's kind of been a standard in this game, I think, pretty much.
Yeah.
All right, Chloe Sebagus, Melissa Coggins, Bartram Trail, Bishop Moore.
There it goes straight up in the air again.
Ball is free, controlled by number 17, that would be Sophie Kusma. Nice catch, number 21, Coggins, nice catch. Casey Coates for the Bears. Still playing with the man advantage here. Melissa Coggins. If you're a man down, Bob, in a situation like this and you've been playing man-to-man, do you continue playing man-to-man or do you move into zone?
Well, we don't because we play a zone defense, but if you're strictly a man-to-man, you just have to...
You keep playing man. I mean, you play what you know.
You play what you know, but you have to... You got to make sure you take care of the area in front of the goal.
Okay. It was Kuzma that started play. Passes it to Hutzel. Lauren Hutzel now. Caroline Beggs inside, takes a shot, finds the back of the net, and they took advantage of the opportunity that was given to them. They were all even at 6.
That was a wide open shot. They've been mixing up their shot selections, too. And, half been high and half been low.
Keeper's got a huge net, but I'll tell you, you know, you've just got so much space you're responsible for, it's just hard to, you know. offense players clearly have an advantage.
Especially from that close in.
Yeah. Right. Chloe Sebagas, the Bishop Moore Hornets. Melissa Coggins, Bartram Trail Bears, taking the draw. To Vegas.
Oh, we're going to see a card here. No, maybe not.
To Vegas. Bishop Moore. Chelsea Worrell. Lindsay Tangeman. Oh, nice pass inside. Good defense there, Bob. That number nine came out of nowhere. That's Courtney Shell, and just kind of deflected that away because that looked like it was going to be a good opportunity for the Hornets.
Oh, they're going to spread it out again, run that clock down. Well, they're in full force now.
Yeah.
They do have all seven out there.
All right. As you approach the line, how many players are allowed to be in the attacking zone?
Well, you can have seven on offense and eight on defense, counting the goalie.
Okay. Girls who are standing at the top of the attack line, I mean, if they could reach your stick over and pick up a loose ball, but they can't
physically
go in.
Correct.
Okay.
They can touch the ball with their stick, but they can't cross with their feet.
Looks like Haley Kakris will start play. Passes back to Lynch Tangeman. Boy, Bartram Trail's defense really hasn't been impressive to me. I mean, it's man-to-man, and you suddenly step free, and like you said, Bishop Moore so fast. But they've done a nice job recovering.
Oh, good check.
I'm not sure the fans like the call, but Sophie Kuzma has it for the Bears.
That was a check towards the body. Look at that speed.
Boy,
she caught it up to her very fast.
Yeah, Travasio. Check that. It's Larinaga. Ball now to Courtney Shell. Flips it ahead to Casey Coates, and the Bears come to the attack. Coates to Hutzel. Hutzel to Beggs. Beggs has been pretty smooth from that position, and there she goes again, ladies and gentlemen. Caroline Beggs and Bartram Trail back in the lead, 7-6. Minute and 25 to play in the half.
Goalie had no chance there.
As fast as Bishop Moore has been, I'm sort of impressed with the quickness of some of the players for Bartram Trail, especially on the offensive end. They just seem to be able to get around a defender when they need to and open up some space for themselves to get a shot.
Well, you can't be a slow team and get this far. The lacrosse is a game of speed. Bishop Moore's just always impressed me. That's their strength, their speed.
Chloe Sebagas for the Hornets and Melissa Coggin for the Bears.
They have a cover.
Christina White on the field now for the Bears, and she has possession. Races to the offensive end. I'm assuming that was a check.
That was a push.
Push. Thank you. Christina White again for the Bears. Casey Coates. Counting down to a minute to play in the opening half. Caroline Beggs. Nicely defended by Bishop Moore. Beggs looked for the opportunity, got turned aside. Flips it back to Melissa Coggins. Coggins flips it out front, Mary Kay Weaver. Weaver, nice run between players. The whistle stops play.
We're going to see a free position shot here.
This is actually a pretty good position to be in, huh, Bob?
Right in the center. I mean, this is the hardest shot for a goalie to defend.
Mary Kay Weaver, nice play. Bishop Moore gets in, tries to take the angle away from her, just unable to. And Weaver gives Bartram trail with 24 seconds to play in the opening half, the biggest lead of the game so far, 2 goals, 8-6 Bears.
That was a piece of cake on that one.
Yeah.
With your players, is there ever a coaching moment where you say, from this mark, you fire your shot? Or is it really just, no, you want to get as tight as you can to take your shot?
Well, it depends on the player, because if you have a slow player, mm-hmm. you know, sometimes they have to take the long shot or just pull it out.
You guys work on that?
Yes, we do. And some teams have plays where they'll pass the ball to somebody down low, and you'll see Vero do that our next game.
Yeah. All right, Chloe Sebagas, Melissa Coggins. We have 24 seconds to play in the opening half. Any idea what the official was in discussion over on the sideline?
No. Right over there asking him what restaurant he should go to for dinner tonight.
Now we have a game on. Bartram Trail. They could get another goal here, go up by 3 by halftime. That would be a huge advantage. All right, ball to Devin Romer. Romer races to the attack.
Exactly.
Check that. Courtney Shell, number 9. 4 seconds ago, Bishop Moore takes the ball away. I think it's going to bring us to halftime. And we are at halftime, the first of two girls' semifinal lacrosse matches. It's 8-6 Bartram Trail at the half.
Sophomore.
Second half, a couple minutes away. Bob, take us through, if you were the coach for Bishop Moore, what would you have said to your team at halftime? You're behind by two goals.
Well, the fact that they're behind, they're certainly not going to have to go with what they've been doing. They're going to have to make some adaptions out there. And the one adaption I'm expecting to see is to see them use that speed more and fast break a little bit more. I'm just surprised at how slow tempo they slowed it down. The fact that they've only had six goals at halftime, they're used to scoring a lot more goals than that.
Bartram Trail, you have a two-goal lead on a team that's rated above you in the state of Florida. Coming in, Bartram Trail rated number 9, Bishop Moore rated number 3. What are you saying to your girls as we start the second half?
Well, I think they're going to have to go. What they're doing is working for them, so you're going to probably see more of the same.
One thing you mentioned to me at the break is that you commented that Bishop Moore's defense seems to be kind of allowing Bartram Trail to sort of run in on goal.
Yeah, you're seeing a lot more of that than you really want to see. They're rolling the crease, and I'm sure Bishop Moore have talked about that at halftime. So we'll see what kind of changes they make.
Possession clearly belonging to Bishop Moore in the first half, although they're behind in the score on the scoreboard by 2. All right, you ready to start second half? Claire Ferry, Melissa Coggan taking the draw for their respective teams, and Bartram Trail comes away with draw control. That's number 15, Haley Hegblood. Again, running in on goal. Bishop Moore turns her away. Caroline Beggs passes inside off the stick of her player, and Trail comes away with it. Number 4, Mary Kay Weaver. Second half, Bob, with a two-goal lead. Are you just wanting to keep your foot on the accelerator, or you wanting to slow things down?
Yeah, you don't want to. You want to go with what's been working.
Okay.
Especially with a lead. You don't want to slow things down yet.
Nice stop there by the goalkeeper initially for Bishop Moore, but ball went back to Bartram Trail. And the goal, I think, number 17 that time, Sophie Kuzma. And we go to a 3-goal lead. That's the largest either team has had. It's been a very, very tightly played first half. But just before the halftime, Bartram Trail jumped out by 2. And now we go to the beginning of the second half. 24 minutes, 18 seconds to play. And they've now staked themselves to a 3-goal lead. Coggins and looks like Claire Ferry taking the draw for the respective teams. And momentum took a big part of this game, don't you think?
Well, if you can score and get the ball back again. There they go.
Yeah, good call, Bob. It's 21. Melissa Coggins coming away with it for the Bears. Back to one of the co-players, number 15, Haley Hegblood.
Bishop Moore's putting a little bit more pressure on the ball out there now.
It's number 3, Casey Coates with the ball for the Lady Bears. Bears look pretty content to run a little bit of clock here. That was Lauren Hutzel with the ball. Hutzel back to Coates. Coates, nice pass inside. Good play by the defense of Bishop Moore. Running free there, number 30, Nicole Vella. How much pressure can you put on the keeper when she's outside?
She's a field player right now. You can check the stick, get the ball, and put it in an empty goal.
Chloe Sebagas. A whistle stopping play.
Illegal check.
It's to Vegas. Lindsay Tangeman. Puts it ahead, number 16, Zoe McFarland. McFarland.
See. They're not going to set up. They're going to, I think they're going to go hard to goal.
Kind of anticipated that as well. But once again, that man-to-man defense seems to be giving them all they can handle today. Claire Ferry, and whistle stopping play there. I'm sure that was a check.
There's a push there.
Claire Ferry will have the start of play for Bishop Moore. Lindsay Tangeman.
I guess it's fair to say that was a push.
Looked like a pretty good contact to me, too. All right. Lindsay Tangeman from 8 meters away. Takes a shot, finds the back of the net.
Much needed goal there.
Yeah, they certainly did. All right, we go 9-7 with 22 minutes to play in the match. For a good offensive player that's quick, that's really quite an advantage, isn't it? 8 meters
if
away.
If you're fast, you live off of that.
Again, I thought Kayla Jones made a nice effort for Archangel, but it's amazing the advantage offensive players do have from close distance. All right. Coming back to the draw, it'll be Melissa Cogden, the Bears, Claire Ferry. For the Hornets. At what point, if this trend continues with Archangel maintaining its lead, do you expect the pressure to begin to show on the Bishop Moore players, or do you think they're just going to play through it all?
Well, we've already seen them put more pressure on the defensive end. Mm-hmm. Right off the bat in the second half. And you also see them going to goal faster instead of setting it up and taking the time.
Yeah, defense is all over. And Thompson for a moment with Bishop Moore. And ultimately the ball ends up on the stick of Jackie Servasio. Servasio Tangeman. Nice catch. Number 16, Zoe McFarland back at Lindsay. Tangeman. Sebagas. Zoe Sebagas for Bishop Moore.
Bartram Trail is double teaming the ball at all times.
Closest stick to the ball when it went out on that shot was Bishop Moore. And it looks like Jackie Servasio has possession. Foul on that play, Bob?
Yes, just a minor foul. Should he go 4 meters behind?
Lindsay Tangeman has the ball for Bishop Moore. I want to get to physical contact here at the next opportunity. Oh, nice pass, nice catch, nice shot. Number 11, Claire Ferry. And the momentum swinging back the other way with 20 minutes and 39 seconds to play in the match. It's now 9-8, Bartram Trail. Bob, you're playing against another player, you know, like we've seen today, and I'm kind of guarding you, checking you. My stick cannot contact your body.
You can never contact the body with a stick, correct?
Even the stick's in both my hands, and I'm just using it to kind of steer you around. I'm not allowed to physically contact you with the stick.
You can use your hand on the stick, okay. Up against you, correct.
All right, we have a timeout. I'm assuming it was Bartram Trail. They've lost a little bit of momentum from their start of the second half anyhow, and certainly the end of the first.
Now they're going to regroup.
Any particular things you've noticed, Bob, in the start of the second half of Bartram Trail that you would, as their coach, say to them at this point?
Yeah, they seem like they're doing the same things. I just say Bishop Moore is putting a little bit more pressure on the defensive end. They're going to go a little bit faster, not being as patient.
Not surprising. I mean, the entire first half, possession of the ball was largely under the control of the Bishop Moore Hornets. So I think we see the second half kind of going in the same manner.
Yeah, they just didn't take advantage of it.
This will be a pretty critical draw control here when you're looking at the match.
Well, again, if you can score and get the ball back, that's important for Bishop Moore to keep the pedal to the metal. Of course, Bartram Trail, they want the ball back. They want to stop the bleeding.
Yeah. So Bishop Moore coaches, they come out of their timeout. Your final word to them would be what?
Get the ball.
Yeah. Let's
control the ball. Get the ball back on the draw control. I like to tell my players that ball is raw meat, and they're hungry dogs.
You say that to girls?
Literally say it. That's it. They want to be talked to that way. When you get up to this level, they are warriors.
I coached my daughter's soccer team when she was 12. I'm not sure I would have used that, but it's nice to know that the girls can be talked to in a forceful manner. I like that. All right, we come back for a draw. We got Claire Ferry for Bishop Moore. We got Melissa Coggins for Bartram Trail. And big moment. Can Bishop Moore keep the momentum?
Drawing to themselves again.
Claire Ferry. The official's call there with the hand in front of her face is significant of what?
Well, you have a 7-inch spear around your head, and the defender's stick cannot enter that spear.
And that call would have been for that.
That's what it was, in the spear. You also can't put your stick with a ball in that spear also. You can't cradle in the spear, because that would be impossible to check.
Jackie Servasio has the ball for Bishop Moore.
With a push.
Oh, nice play. Holy smokes. How about that? Kayla Jones coming up large for Bartram Trail. She's really had a really good match, I think. Made some big plays.
The Claire's have been spot on also. Let's see how she does here. Oops, she forced that one.
Yep. Bartram Trail is number 4, Mary Kay Weaver. Running to the attack, Bishop Moore shuts it down. That was Lauren Hutzel coming in from the wing, and I mean...
Bartram Trail answers. That was big.
10-8, 19-22 to play in the match. Resembles some of what we saw in the first half. I mean, for some reason, Bartram Trail managed to find a lot of space around the goal mouth. And Bishop Moore's defense, I don't know, slow to pick up on it, Bob, or just not attentive?
Well, it was more of a fast break situation, so it wasn't against their settled defense.
There you go, Claire Ferry, Melissa Coggins taking the draw for their respective teams. Bishop Moore. That's Chelsea Worrell with the ball. That was probably a trip inadvertent, huh, Bob?
It was a push.
Push. Claire Ferry. Chloe Sebagas.
Yeah, they're looking to go to goal a lot faster than they were in the first half.
So McFarland up top with the ball. Passes it out to number 7. Haley Kakris. Kakris to Sebagas. Nice pass over the top. Big time one-timer there for Bishop Moore, but the goalkeeper comes up large. Lindsay Tangeman ends up with a loose ball.
That was a kick save.
Yes. Kayla Jones playing goalkeeper. Bartram Trail, number 1, Lindsay Tangeman. McFarland, Sebagas.
Great pass.
Tangeman.
Whoa, good save.
Great saves, but boy, I'll tell you what, the ball keeps getting back on the sticks of the Bishop Moore girls. And after a struggle to get possession, and Bishop Moore has it. It looks like a whistle-stopping play, and Bishop Moore will retain possession here. Number 4, Chelsea Worrell.
A little bit more physical contact than they want in the girls' game.
When the ball's down like that and you're running around with your eyes on the ground looking for it, there's going to be physical contact. What's the referee looking for? Someone gaining some advantage from it?
Correct, yeah. They may let it play on if it's no advantage.
All right, Claire Ferry, inside. There's a shot up high. Shot taken by Chelsea Worrell. Ball goes out of play first. Closest to the ball went out, number 22, Jackie Servasio. And Servasio starts the action for Bishop Moore. Sebagus. Nice pass inside. Yeah, that was nice. Zoe McFarland. Great assist. Got the ball up high. Nice pass inside. We go 10-9.
Bishop Moore is forcing the play a little bit faster than they were in the first half.
Anything different about their offensive set? You got Bartram Trail playing man-to-man. Is your plan now, let's draw the defense out by taking our players and keeping them on the perimeter?
Well, they're actually playing, even though they're playing a man-to-man, it's a backer type of zone they're playing. If you watch the ball, there's always a second person that the ball carrier has to beat at all times. So if you look at the defender on the ball, there's another defender about 5 meters, 4 meters behind her.
Claire Ferry comes away with the ball. Nice stick check, but a whistle stops play.
And a spear.
Claire Ferry will start the action for Bishop Moore. Flips it ahead to Bridget Larinaga. Once again, that man-to-man defense has really been, you know, intense for Bartram Trail. I mean, Tangeman comes away with the ball, but it was a really nice play by the defender for Bartram Trail, Kuzma. Jackie Servasio. The distance here, Bob, is 4 meters.
4 meters.
Between the girl with the ball and the girl who committed the foul. Chloe Sebagas.
A lot of pressure on the ball.
Yeah.
There she goes.
Yeah. Kind of watching off the ball a little bit, too. And
yeah, she forced that pass.
Bishop Moore, their due. They keep coming up with a lot of the loose balls. Claire Ferry, possession for the Hornets. Number 13, Larinaga. McFarland. Oh, nice pass,
open.
Nice pass, nice pass. That was Chelsea Worrell on the assist from Kaylee Kakris. And we're level. 15 minutes, 15 seconds of play in the match. It's 10-10. Basically can't get much closer than that.
A lot of excitement in the stands here from the Bishop Moore crowd.
All right, let's talk about Bartram Trail for a moment. Had a lot of momentum going into the half. We played 10 minutes in the second half. You've had a 3-goal lead, and it's now level. You scored once in the second half. They've given up, what, 4? Yeah.
Well, I think they just, I'm sure you're going to see more of the same of what they're doing. They seem like they're playing good defense. It's just that Bishop Moore has found out a way to attack it a little bit better.
In possession, my goodness. I mean, it's still very much in favor of Bishop Moore. Ferry and Coggin.
There they
go again. A tall height for Ferry. Wins out. Larinaga, a whistle-stopping play.
And the spear.
Yep. Draw control is so critical right now in the second half, favoring, once again, Bishop Moore, who had a lot of draw control in the first half. Bridget Larinaga. Out front to Chloe Sebagas. Lindsay Tangeman. Back to number 22, Jackie Servasio. Chloe Sebagas. Tangeman. Once again, Bartram Trail. As you've called it all day, Bob, their defense has been impressive, but they've had so much possession on the sticks of Bishop Moore. Eventually, it kind of wears you down, doesn't it?
Good stop.
Nice play there. Kayla Jones coming up large on the shot by Sebagas.
It's been a big difference in this game. The Bartram Trail goalie hasn't been playing so well.
Yeah.
You'd see a little bit difference in the score.
With that much possession, your defense always under that much pressure, that just can't be good for your overall game, can it?
And it's gonna break at some point.
Nice play, nice pass out to Devin Romer. A whistle stopping play there. Romer will have possession for Bartram Trail. Flips it ahead to Lauren Hutzel. Hutzel, nice move. Bishop Moore defense, though, did step up and turn her away. Caroline Beggs behind the net. Oh, nice pass inside. Nice play.
Hit the post.
Bartram Trail retains possession as Casey Coates. That was a nice exchange there by Bartram Trail. Nice pass inside. Excellent catch. Good shot. No luck. Number 17, Sophie Kusma. Ball checked away. Coming away with it, Nicole Vella, goalkeeper for Bishop Moore. As she runs out into the open field, nice pass. Lindsay Tangeman. Ahead to Bridget Larinaga. Nice pass inside. That was Chelsea Worrell finding space. Bit of a fast break move, huh?
She's been finding that open spot in the 8 meters all day long.
And after being behind by 3 goals, Bishop Moore has now reclaimed the lead. 12 minutes, 39 seconds to play. 11-10, Hornets.
Bartram Trail's going to have to collect ourselves here.
Yeah, it certainly has.
Certainly going to have to try to do something different, particularly in the draw control. I'm just surprised that they're continuing to draw to themselves. I would think that they should try to draw away from the center there and into the crowd.
With two sticks like that, how much opportunity do you have to flip the ball a distance? I mean, if one player is trying to flip it up in the air themselves and the other one's trying to travel a distance, who's going to win that argument?
Well, it depends. It's the fastest stick.
Okay.
We always teach our girls to watch the goal, watch the ref, and try to time when they're
right.
going to blow that whistle.
We come back to play. Number 22, Jackie Servacio, and draw control for Bishop Moore. And again, draw control for Bishop Moore. That's been said a lot today. Claire Ferry. Pass a little behind, and it will roll out. That was not a shot. That was a bad pass. So the ball now goes to Bartram Trail, correct?
Well, the goalie was closest to it. So.
Oh, really?
Well,
so when there's a pass like that...
That's Bartram Trail's ball for Bogan on the bounce, and it goes to the goalkeeper.
Okay. How easy or hard to control the ball from the goalkeeper's stick? I mean, can she make accurate throws, or is that really challenging given the size of the net?
Well, it's harder than a regular stick, but these two goalies are very experienced.
Nice pass off the stick of number 5, Christina White. And Bishop Moore, it looks like, has possession. Considered a force-out play there, Bob?
Yes, it was.
Okay. I think it's Claire Ferry from my distance. I think that's who has it, number 11 for Bishop Moore. And once again, Bishop Moore retains possession. Nice stick check. Taken away by the Bears.
Good check.
Going both ways. That was really good. It was Coates that took it away from Ferry, and then it was Larinaga that took it away from Coates. The ball now on the stick of Bridget Larinaga for Bishop Moore.
Bishop Moore is spreading it out now.
And it looks like, for a minute there, almost looked like the defense suddenly backed away from all the pressure they've been putting on the Hornets.
And a spear.
Chloe Sebagas for Bishop Moore. Haley Kakris. Jackie Servacio, and a whistle stops play. Okay. You know what this call is, Bob?
Might be an offsides.
Which would be? Define offside for me.
Well, you're only allowed to have 7. Yeah, well, no, okay. It was probably the referee must have miscounted.
Okay. So we just pick up where we left off. Servacio. If someone were offside, you would lose possession?
Correct.
Okay. Tight defense. Had
bad
a shot
angle.
There from Sebagas.
Bad
sorry,
angle.
Sebagas with the ball now.
Bishop Moore's been doing a really good job of, when they do miss a shot, getting the ball back.
Yeah, I'm with you. I'm kind of surprised, frankly. You take shots, and you miss, and the ball ends up back on one of your player's sticks. They've been so fortunate that way. Bridget Larinaga. She's 8 meters out, Bob. This is a direct?
Well, this is a direct, but it's a bad angle. She's going to have to veer to her left.
Once again, coming up big, Kayla Jones. Kayla Jones comes up big, but the ball goes back to
good defense.
Yeah. The ball still stays with Bishop Moore. It was Chris to Sebagas. Once again, nice stop. Kayla Jones, she's kept it in the match.
She hit the goalie right in the stick. It was just a poor shot.
And then turnover again. Claire Ferry now. Possession for Bishop Moore. Jackie Servasio behind the net. Noah McFarland. Out front, Tangeman to Ferry. Ferry Tangeman. Tangeman McFarland. Bishop Moore moving the ball on the perimeter. 22, Jackie Servasio. Servasio on a high pass to Chloe Sebagas to the back of the net for Bishop Moore. And they now have the biggest lead they've had the entire game.
That was a good quick stick there.
It was.
It was in the stick for about half a second.
Almost like a one-timer in hockey.
A one-timer.
Yep. We go 12-10 with 8 minutes, 18 seconds to play in the match. And it looks like Bartram Trail calling timeout. Got to stop the bleeding. Hey, Bob.
They got to figure something out. Whatever they're doing now is not working.
Got to give them credit. Their defense has been under pressure the entire match. They've been in it the entire match. Offensively in the second half, how many possessions for them, Bob? Three?
It wasn't much.
Yeah.
I'm not counting them, but there wasn't too many opportunities.
As momentum begins to slide away, okay, you had a three-goal lead, and now momentum's gone the other way, and it's slowly kind of bleeding away from you. What do you say to your girls? How do you get them to pick their heads up?
Well, from the Bishop Moore side, it's a tough call because you got the lead. Time is on your side, but what's working for you is forcing the play. So you have to say, do you continue to do that, or do you slow it down and take advantage of having the lead with a short clock?
What about the Bears?
With the Bears, they're going to have to even put more pressure on the defense. They're going to have to force Bishop Moore to make some bad passes or something to get that ball back. I really think that they got to do something about the draw.
Yeah. But how do you get your kids to get their head off their chin? I mean, right now, it's got to be tough for Bartram Trail. They're, you know, they've seen it slip away from them.
Yeah, but there's no tomorrow. I mean, for some of these girls, this could be their last game. So you have to invigorate them with that. They can't leave anything on the field.
Yeah. So if you're talking to them, technically you're talking, hey, we got to do a better job with draw control.
I think they have to go about it a different way. I really think that they're going to draw for a distance, mm-hmm. not draw straight up in the air, but draw over your shoulder to another player.
You're coaching your team. You work on both aspects of draw like that. You practice your team in terms of learn how to draw the ball so it comes to us.
Sure.
You also work on how we get the travel distance.
Or
to play.
Just put a different player in there.
Uh-huh.
It's, if you get the same player in there, the same thing's happening over and over again. You just have to change it up.
One thing we've noticed pretty much the whole game with Claire Ferry taking the draw for Bishop Moore, she clearly has a height advantage. So flipping the ball up to herself has really paid dividends for them.
I'm sure she's going to continue that.
And speaking of, Bob, you're right. They've just moved a new player to take the draw for Bartram Trail. It's number 4, Chelsea Worrell. Let's see if there's a change here. You were saying?
I'm thinking the same thing. I'm thinking out loud what's going to be the change here. Still to herself.
Yeah, looks like Larinaga. And Bishop Moore again. Boy, possession. Tangeman.
They're not going to be in any hurry now.
Yeah, Claire Ferry. Tangeman, Larinaga. Looks like they are. It's kind of keeping possession and killing some clock. Claire Ferry, Haley Kakris, Chloe Sebagas.
This is just how they started off playing the game in the first half.
Yeah. Only now you had a purpose. Now you're really looking to run some clock.
Yeah, you're going to have to put pressure on the ball.
You know, I'm a little surprised. I mean, Bartram Trail, are they in a zone now, Bob? Is that kind of what they're doing?
Or no, they're still man-to-man.
Okay. I just noticed that in the first half, they squeezed so much distance down that there really was no breathing space for the Bishop Moore players. Now it looks like there's space everywhere, especially on the outside of the field.
Right, well, that's because Bishop Moore is a lot more spread out now.
Okay. So this is more a result of Bishop Moore spreading the field.
Correct.
Okay.
And they're going to have to go out now, just not on the ball, but on the other players. That was it.
All right, Claire Ferry back to possession. Chloe Sebagas. Boy, they are really spreading the field wide. Jackie Servasio, Lindsay Tangeman, Claire Ferry.
Yeah, they're going to be no hurry to score. Even if they have a shot, you're not going to see them take a shot now, because you know, you can score, and you got to go to the draw control. The other team can get the ball back over and over again.
Yeah.
So the best thing here they can do is run the clock down.
Nice check by number 9 for the Bears. That's Courtney Schell. And check the ball away from Bridget Larinaga, and Schell comes possession. Boy, this is a big possession for Bartram Trail, isn't it, Bob?
Well, there's just 5 minutes left in the game, and they're down 2. They know what they have to do. They have to score at least 2 goals here.
Pass to Lauren Hutzel. Hutzel looking inside, no one running inside for her. Caroline Beggs.
Up, you're going to see a yellow card. That was not a good time for that.
Yeah. I think that's number 16, Zoe McFarland, to the sideline. It's a 2-minute penalty, Bob.
That'll be 2 minutes, and it's unreleasable, meaning if they score, she still stays out.
In some sports, a couple of yellow cards yield a red and you're done. Is there a rule like that in lacrosse?
You get 2 yellow cards, you're out of the game.
Okay. And they can't replace you?
After the second one, you can. After your 2 minutes, somebody else would...
So if I lose a player to 2 yellows, I could bring another player in their place after they...
Correct, after the 2 minutes penalty's up.
All right, in the interim, Caroline Beggs, from 8 meters out and a bad angle, races in, scores. Bartram Trail still in it.
Yeah, that was an important goal there.
It was.
Takes a little pressure off their defense.
And you can almost sense, you know, it's got to lift your spirits some too. Go, hey, 5 minutes ago, we're down by a goal. Next most important thing?
Got to get the ball back.
Up the draw control.
I know I've said that over and over again, but these draw controls are so important.
Well, in big games they are. And in a tight match, you're right. All right, here we go. We have 5:34 to play. It's now 12-11. Bishop Moore on top. Mary Kay Weaver, I'm sorry, number 4. I think I gave that wrong name out on the last draw. That's Mary Kay Weaver, number 4, for a Bartram Trail, and she's drawing against Claire Ferry for Bishop Moore.
Yep.
And Ferry comes away with it for the Hornets.
She's been doing a great job on good draw control.
Yeah.
Very important part of why they're in the lead. Double teamed.
Now, the boys' game has a rule about having to put the ball into the offensive end of the field within a certain amount of time. Any rule like that in your girls'
game?
Not at all. All right, go 22, Jackie Servasio, which, by the way, we're going to have to shift our gears here in the afternoon, late afternoon, to do boys, which I'm kind of looking forward to. Oh, nice pass inside.
So she's not going to shoot?
You're right about that. You called that one. That was Worrell. Tangerman, why couldn't you take that shot, I wonder? I mean, boy.
Well, they score. They'd have to go to the draw control, and potentially you could lose the ball over and over again. Oh.
Nice catch, nice pass. I don't know. That's Haley Kakris. Chloe Sebagas. Kind of a dangerous pass, but she pulled it off.
She got away with it.
Yeah.
Another dangerous pass.
Tangerman racing on
she's
goal,
gonna take
and she's
going
to take the shot.
you could see she had that look in her eyes. She was going to go hard to goal and take the shot. And it was wide open for her.
I guess I'm kind of looking at this thing going, did Bartram think she was going to pull off? Because, I mean, nobody even made a play toward the...
They probably thought she was going to pull up.
Yeah.
But one thing, Bishop Moore, they can pretty much get away with that a little bit better than most teams because they're winning draw control so much.
Yeah. All right, you got 4:27 to play, two-goal lead, 13-11. How much is fatigue going to be a factor at this point, or is that really not the issue?
I'm sure these girls have a lot of adrenaline going through them.
Okay. Claire Ferry and Coggins.
Again.
Yeah. Whistle stops play.
It was in the spear. Well, there's going to be a yellow card there. That's really going to make it hard for Bartram Trail here when you're down a player for 2 minutes and there's only 4 minutes left.
Yeah, and Sophie Kutzman's been a big-time player for them today. Made a lot of behind-the-scenes plays defensively, scored a couple goals offensively.
And you will not see Bishop Moore shoot here. They're going to spread out. In fact, Bartram Trail's offsides, but no penalty there because Bishop Moore already had the ball. Well, there'll be an 8-meter shot, but you're going to see an 8-meter, 12-meter.
12-meter, okay. This is Chelsea Worrell.
This will be indirect.
And this was for the offside?
Yeah, they changed their mind.
So all that went on, and the clock hadn't started, and they're just
they want to make sure they get it right.
Got it. All right, number 22, Jackie Servasio, Lindsay Tanchman, and Bishop Moore again. And in no hurry, Claire Ferry, nice move. Larinaga. Sebag is back at Larinaga. Chloe Sebagas.
Clock's still running.
Yeah. You come this far. It's been a long season.
I'm very surprised there.
Yeah.
Really surprised.
Well, I'm not surprised that Larinaga comes away. I mean, that Bishop Moore came away with it. They seem to have that good fortune. And with 2 minutes and 44 seconds to play in the match, Claire Worrell grows the lead to 3 goals for Bishop Moore. It's 14-11.
That actually, I think, is helpful to Bartram Trail that they scored there. Now they at least have the opportunity to get the ball back, score, get the ball back, score, get the ball back. And I've seen it happen. That's why Bishop Moore, I think the best thing for them is to run the clock down, not to take a shot there.
We have a timeout on the field. I would assume it's Bartram Trail. 2:44 to play. Kind of get a feeling it's kind of slipping away, don't you?
3-goal lead with 2 minutes and 44 seconds left. That's going to be tough to overcome.
Yeah. Kind of felt early on as tight as the game was. It was such a well-played first half. Not that the second half has been badly played at all. So, again, been a great match to watch. But... you reach a point in a game where you kind of look at the scoreboard and you begin to go, man, kind of over.
Well, I saw one game this year where a team was down by 1 minute, where there was 1 minute left in the game and they're down by 3 when they scored. And sure enough, the other team came back, scored 3 goals. They just kept getting the ball back. Working the clock is much more important than scoring a goal here.
Yeah.
This has been a very exciting game. I'll tell you, I knew this was going to be close. Just
you said that from the beginning. This probably the best game of the day. If you look at the TV or the TV monitor right now, you can see the coaching staff from Bartram Trail. I'm sure they're trying their best to encourage those girls to. Yeah, I think he's pointing at the clock now, saying, "Okay, this is it." Kind of what you said earlier.
Sure.
There's no tomorrow.
Got to take chances.
2:44 to play. If we lose by five or lose by one, we're going home.
Certainly can't take your time. When they come down to get that ball, they're going to have to go to goal fast.
Yeah.
Score and get the ball back. Score and get the ball back.
Bishop Moore, of course, I think is just saying, hey, let's control this and let's control this draw.
Time is on our side.
Yeah.
That's what they're saying.
Yeah. Does either team at this moment think about the finals? I mean, are you Bishop Moore, are you starting to think to yourself, ooh.
I hope not.
Nobody's looking ahead.
Crazier things have happened.
Okay.
You know, they've got to get through this 2 minutes and 44 seconds first, and then they've got all night to think about the finals.
All right. Claire Ferry for Bishop Moore and Melissa Coggins for Bartram Trail taking a draw. As Bob's pointed out, this is going to be one of the keys. Kind of has been the key to the match all day, I think.
Yeah, if Bartram Trail gets the ball back, it's all over.
Yeah, there it is. Claire Ferry has possession for Bishop Moore. And suspect they're not going to take another shot no matter what it looks like, Bob.
I'd be very surprised.
It's number seven, Haley Kakris, almost turning it over. But again, the good fortune of Bishop Moore continues.
Well, the penalty's over on the Bartram Trail player. She's re-entering the game, so now we'll be at full strength, 7-7.
And you would expect a true double team on the ball?
Would have to. Can't just man up.
Yeah.
Double team the ball.
Kakris back to Ferry to Larinaga.
There's the double team right there.
Benjamin, yep. With so much space right now for Bishop Moore, it looks like.
They're
kind of chasing
the ball.
Yeah. Lindsay Tangerman. Bridget Larinaga back to Tangerman. A bit of a hard contact there. A minute and 30 to play. Bridget Larinaga runs into the attacking zone, but
she will not shoot.
Yeah, Bob was saying all along, I'm not going to probably shoot at this. Chloe to Vegas. Bishop Moore. Kakris. Servasio now behind the net with the ball. Counting down toward a minute to play in the match.
Got to double the ball.
Jackie Servasio in open space. Lindsay Tangerman, and clearly at this point it's Bishop Moore just running the clock off. Tangerman to Ferry. Ferry in space.
Bartram Trail has nothing to be ashamed of tonight.
No,
they really
no.
played their heart out.
Yep. With timeout by the officials,
another
the clerk
got
a yellow card. Bob, give me a guess on that.
It was a hit to the head.
Okay.
Very protective of that, obviously.
Yeah, yeah. Ferry going to shoot here?
I don't think so. What the heck, maybe she might, but.
Yeah, she did.
She's played such a strong game on the draw control.
Yep.
I guess that was just icing on the cake for her today.
15-11. You have 29 seconds to play in the match. And again, what has been a well-played match by both sides. Now I think you kind of get that feeling of your Bartram Trail that it's over.
Yeah, it's going to start creaking into their heads.
Yeah. And for Bishop Moore, you know, a sense of we get to play on. I mean, coming into the match, looking at the seedings, certainly Bishop Moore would have been more highly seeded, is a more highly seeded team, and one would expect sort of the favorite, I suppose.
Well, they know they got their work cut off from the next game.
Yeah. And Ferry again. Looks like Bishop Moore again for Vegas, kind of running out the clock.
They've just crushed Bartram Trail on the draw.
Yeah. Chelsea Worrell grows the lead to 16-11. Any reaction?
Well, that's what I thought you'd see Bishop Moore doing more.
Yeah, an early
all game long. Yeah, that was a fast break. Minimal passes, quick shooting. And again, the largest lead of the game.
Yeah. Yeah, possession, I think, is going to end up being one of the real big elements to this particular game when it's all said and done. Bishop Moore just retained possession for such a long stretch of the game.
And they get the ball back again.
Yeah. Worrell.
I was going to say, sooner or later, they're going to have to start calling a charge on that. And that's exactly what that was. They called the charge.
So she had her defensive player had her position established.
Correct. She ran right into her.
And that does it. We've reached the end of our first semifinal game and punching their ticket to the finals, the Bishop Moore Lady Hornets, 16-11. And they're going to await the winner of our second semifinal match. It will be coming up here probably in about 30 minutes. Again, a nice congratulations to Bishop Moore for a well-played match and a great season so far, with a hope to come away with the title. And a real tip of the hat to Bartram Trail Bob for all that they put into today's match.
Much closer nothing, game than the score.
Yeah, absolutely
indicated.
Was. Nothing
much
to hang your head about. Okay, we will pick you up at the second game of the semifinals a little bit later. Thank you.
We appreciate your support. Lacrosse in the